Dhananjay Sinha, Emkay Global Financial, is with us now. Dhananjay, good afternoon. So, macro worries versus micro tailwinds. Your thoughts on how we are positioned right now?
So I think, you're right. I think the way we are basically looking at is that some of the tailwinds that we have had with respect to interest rate scenario, liquidity, currency, and the oil prices, those have actually turned adverse. So we have seen, the 10-year yield, for instance, on G-Sec has actually increased to close to a little less than 8%, and you have seen currency actually getting into a sort of a correction mode, and we believe that both yields and the currency is still some way to go. So our expectation is that, possibly 10-year fair value, which is about 8% for us, can actually be exceeding that, and rupee can actually depreciate to 67-70 level. So there is a certain amount of disquiet with respect to financial market, and the stability that we had seen up till now can actually be somewhat disturbed. So that is one. And the third, of course, with the rising crude prices, I think it has got implication both for the fiscal scenario and also for the external balances. We are of the view that, the current account deficit could exceed 2.5% of the GDP and trade deficit closer to 6%. I think that will have a impact for the fiscal deficit also, because you can see subsidy rising for kerosene and LPG. It will also have an impact on the way the government is trying to put its disinvestment targets, how it will be achieved. So there is an implication for that. And also, I would say there is some rollback on excise duty because of the rising crude prices. So there is a sort of a compromise as far as excise duty collection is concerned. So I think these worries are there. But at the same time, the rising commodity prices also has translated into better sales growth of companies. So if you look at the non-finance companies, the sales growth up till now has hovered around 10 to 11%. That could go up. So there is some momentum as far as demand scenario is concerned. We'll have to see whether that sort of filters down into profit growth for companies or not in the context of rising commodity prices. We'll have to see. But with a lag, I guess the margin pressure would also come around. Hence, we believe that the earnings growth for Nifty or Sensex companies, I think, looks to be in the range of 10 to 12% in the foreseeable future is what we are looking at.
Dhananjay, the other obviously factor that the market is now dealing with is Karnataka. Now, yes. we hear commentary that elections don't really matter and the market moves on in a matter of days. But is Karnataka different? I mean, if there is an adverse verdict here, could it be really damaging to sentiment?
So I think the way I look at it is that from a policy perspective, I think it doesn't matter, because I think the kind of policy emphasis that this government has had in the last 4 years have been virtually the same as the previous government. So there is a considerable focus on the welfare schemes of the previous government. There has been furthermore momentum that has been added, for instance, NAREGA, focus on farm sector, rural sector, etc., housing for all these things are there, power for all. So those kind of welfare scheme is there. So I think schemes are there. So it's kind of sort of a different level of similar stuff. So I think from a policy standpoint, it doesn't matter much. But I think from a flow standpoint, it does certainly, it certainly matters, because important thing to note is that in the last 4 years, our markets have been run very strongly on the back of retail participation. So you've seen positive mutual fund flows since the Modi government came to power. Prior to that, for almost like 6 years, there were virtually outflow every redemption every month. So I think from a market standpoint, the election outcome will definitely be of relevance. I think Karnataka election will tell us whether the key issues with respect to farm sector, employment, etc., So are those things are those things really mattering to electorates or not, or whether the electorates are still very gung-ho about the prospects under the current government. So that is something that will be outlined in this election. There is some takeaways from Gujarat election as well, where I think in the rural areas the BJP government did not do so well. So we'll have to see that, because going forward it could actually create a leading indicator for what could happen in Rajasthan, Madhya Pradesh and other major states in the north, which are predominantly rural and agrarian as well. So I think the verdict in this election, in the Karnataka state election, will be very critical from a flow standpoint, because I think the retail investors have somehow shown a very marked positive sentiment associated with this government. So that's how I think I would consider from a market standpoint this election is relevant.
Okay, just pull out the intraday chart of TI Finance. We normally don't talk about it, of course, the erstwhile Tube Investment, but looked like the earning of the date today so far, and that stock right now making high of the date. That's TI Financial Holding, of course, that's well Tube Investment. There was a post result, there was this uptick, then some profit taking, but now fresh round of buying emerging on that stock. So interesting. Dhananjay, in your strategy report you mentioned you're positive on select corporate facing banks. Would that include ICICI, or would Axis be your preferred pick?
So if you look at the banking sector, I think good thing is that you have a positive momentum as far as credit growth is concerned. You know, if you look at barring the penultimate fortnight of March, I think the credit growth has recovered to something like 11.5%. That's compared to, let's say, 5% a year back. So there is a sort of a momentum that is there. I think an incremental growth is largely coming from retail lending. We think that this year this momentum should continue. We are looking at a systemic loan growth of about 15 to 16%, and I think some of the so you have a this whole retail banks who have actually been doing well in terms of performance, especially those banks who have the growth capital. We think that some of the corporate lenders who have been aggressively moving towards the retail lending, including banks like ICICI Bank, look to be in a scenario where they will actually do well in terms of overall growth on the back of rising credit growth. And I think the management of ICICI Bank sounded pretty positive with respect to the outlook on growth, and they definitely have a reasonably strong growth capital. Tier 1 capital is fairly high, even if I consider we consider stressed asset and take a aggressive haircut out there. So I think the guidance with respect to growth, profitability, credit costs, etc., look to be positive. So I think for some of these banks there is a turnaround as far as profitability, etc., is concerned. So I think one can consider those as value picks. Yeah.
Okay, well, as the ticker is alerting us right now, IOC, look at the sharp move in these stocks, and this is what we've been discussing on the show earlier as well. So let's pull out IOC, BPCL, HPCL. Anyway, these stocks have been soaring. Dhananjay, we were just discussing what could be the possibility here. I mean, one is that Anuj was pointing out that, you know, maybe after the Karnataka elections, then maybe we start seeing some aggressive price increases, and maybe that is what traders are playing right now. How do you account for these kind of moves in OMCs at current prices, and what's your call on this space?
So for the oil marketing companies, we have been skeptical. I think the prices have corrected largely in the context of rising crude prices, and the worry is that the free market linked price mechanism will be disturbed, and I think that is what has happened. I think in the context of series of state and central elections, central government elections that are lined up, I think that worry will still be there. So I think as crude has shown evidence of being hard on the rising side, I think more of these concerns will be there. So while in the market people believe that after a steep correction that we've seen over the last 1 year or so, there is rally out there. I would sort of refrain from getting too gung-ho about it. I think we'll look at this this sector maybe after the general election. So I think uncertainty is definitely there, and you know, unless you are looking at let's say 3 year view or beyond, or 2 year view or beyond, is I would want to wait for some more time for better valuation.
Okay, Dhananjay, we leave it there. Thanks a lot for joining us today.
Thank you.
That's the view from Emkay. By the way.